Hey guys, Paolo from ConcaChops.com here, and welcome back to our quick tip lesson series, where we're checking out different fills, phrases, and concepts to incorporate into our conga playing. Now, before we get started, make sure you hit like and subscribe, and turn on your notifications for the channel so you know when our next lesson drops. In today's lesson, I want to go over a couple of simple variations centered around the downbeat of the two side of the clave that we can use to add some variety to our tumbao. Now, for these specific examples, we're going to be using our two-drum tumbao, where we play the tumbaora on the two side of the clave as our foundation. So if you need a quick refresher, make sure you check out last week's lesson before we get started. For this first variation, we're going to learn a pattern that works really well at faster tempos and gives the tumbao a little bit of breathing room, rhythmically speaking, but doesn't disturb our flow of having a constant groove. So we'll work on this as a four-bar phrase in 2-3 clave. For our first two bars, we'll play our modern one-drum tumbao. When we get to the third bar, we'll play a right-hand slap on beat 1, followed by a left-hand slap on beat 2, before we get to our two low-drum open tones. Let's check it out. The sticking here is totally up to you. And generally speaking, there's no right or wrong way to stick something within the tumbao pattern. There are certain common tendencies that we all share. But in the end, the sticking can simply be whatever feels comfortable for you, as long as it helps you obtain the sound and the feel that you're going for. For example, at a faster tempo, I might simply leave a rest on the end of 3 to make the groove a bit more comfortable. But this might make the groove feel a bit empty at a more moderate tempo, which is fine if that's what you're going for. But because the notes will be so close together at faster tempos, this brief rest will most likely go unnoticed. For our next variation, we're going to continue using the first two quarter notes on the two side of the clave to help us create a bit of space in the groove. But this time, when we get to the third bar, we'll play a left-hand open tone on beat 1, followed by a left-hand slap tone on beat 2 to allow us to get to the tumbaora more comfortably. Now, at these more moderate tempos, the sticking isn't really all that crucial, in the sense that we have enough time between each note to pull off the groove no matter how we're sticking it. But as we pick up speed, the choice between playing a stroke with our right or left hand, or leaving an eighth note rest, could make all the difference in terms of how the pattern flows. Now, although it might seem a bit unnatural at first, to play both of the first two quarter notes in the third bar with our left hand, you'll see that since we're going from an open tone to a slap, both of which are on the edge of the drum, as we pick up speed, it really allows us to get to the tumbaora with our right hand more comfortably. Now, in a musical context, we'd usually only play either of these patterns as variations once every 16 bars or even just a couple times throughout the course of an entire song. So, we wouldn't really be building a constant 2 or 4 bar groove with these as the foundation unless it was something deliberate, for example, in the mambo section of a song, which is something we'll look at in upcoming lessons. So, for this next example, just so we can get some practice time in with these, let's play these variations each once every 8 bars at a bit faster tempo. So we'll play our variation with a slap on the downbeat in the 7th bar of the first 8-bar phrase, and the variation with an open tone on the downbeat in the 7th bar of the following 8-bar phrase. Now let's work on that same thing at a much faster tempo over one of our conga chops timba montuno loops. Now, as with all of our patterns, at faster tempos, we might need to slightly adjust the sticking, placing a rest here or there instead of a ghost tone, or adding some accents to help the pattern really swing. Let's check it out.
1, 2, 3, 4.
though these are just a couple simple variations that we created using very few notes. Now, working on all the patterns and variations interchangeably that we're covering across all of these lessons will help you start to develop some creative freedom when it comes to playing your tumbao. Just remember that not everything we'll study here is applicable in every context. You'll want to be very picky as to when you use these different patterns, depending on the musical context that you're in. Now, in a salsa setting, it might be okay to use these sparingly depending on the particular style. In a Latin jazz setting, for example, which is generally a bit more open in terms of the structured freedom of the accompaniment, it might feel good to use these a bit more often and closer together. This is something that you'll develop a feel for over time the more you study different styles, players, and recordings, and start to develop your own musical taste based on what you want your playing to sound and feel like. So take the time to work on these patterns slowly with a metronome at first. Focus on the sticking and getting a nice clear sound out of each tone, and make sure you're aware of which side of the clave you're on when you're playing them. The specific variations we covered in this lesson work fine when played on either side of the clave, just as long as the following bar emphasizes the corresponding accents to that particular side of the clave. So make sure you clap the clave along as you listen to or sing each example so you can gain a deeper understanding of how they work together and complement one another. If you want to learn more about what we do on Conga Chops, come check us out at congachops.com. We've got an incredible library of step-by-step courses and lessons, over 10 hours of exclusive practice loops, hand-picked Spotify playlists for each pertinent lesson on the site, and an amazing community forum where you can meet and discuss with other members as well as get one-on-one feedback for everything you're practicing. Just click the link below to grab a free 7-day trial so you can explore the site and find out for yourself why congachops.com is the number one online community for percussionists. Don't forget to show your support by giving this video a like, leaving a comment down below as to what you'd like to see me cover next, and hitting subscribe and turning on your notifications so you can catch our new videos each week. I'll see you in the next lesson.